During their interface with the Public Accounts Committee of Parliament, where they appeared to respond to queries raised in the Auditor General's report for the financial year 2021-2022, officials of Butabika National Referral Mental Hospital expressed concerns over the recent upsurge in the admission of mental health cases at the facility.
Unfortunately, it is something that has not been attended to much previously as a country. We have not been attending much to mental health problems. It is much better to deal with them before they become so serious enough to warrant an admission.
Established in 1955 with the official bed capacity of 550, its patients' admission schedules have surpassed 1,000 inpatients, which represents an occupancy rate of 150%. The Auditor General's report noted that the available staff are overstretched and patients' welfare compromised, which has heavily affected service delivery.
The bed capacity is being increased incrementally to reduce on the high bed occupancy. Since 2020, we've had added 100 beds in the new extensions, including the one we just talked about earlier. This drive is ongoing, but our efforts have been hindered by insufficient development budgets.
Because of those drug abuses, mental health issues are increasing. So, two things. I wanted to ask whether they have an informer system of how to pick these people in society.
In the financial year under review, Butabika Hospital budgeted to admit 9,350 patients, but due to efforts in supporting outpatients and community outreaches, the number reduced to 7,035 patients. Legislators wondered about the scourge behind the upsurge of the mental health cases.
I am trying to look at your page 4. Imagine you had planned to admit 9,350 patients. You can imagine your plan is on the higher side.
Why don't they have, as a psychiatrist, a plan to have an upstream approach? Maybe set up a mental health institute and they tackle these mental problems from the time before they appear in the hospital.
MPs on PAC also asked Butabika Hospital to explain why more men are more prone to mental illness compared to women, based on the statistics of admission at the facility. Butabika attributed this to drug abuse, which is most associated with men.
The number of male mental health patients is almost double the number of females. Do we have some research on that, why that is?
The challenge is that we have a lot of alcohol and substance abuse problems, and those are usually skewed towards the male folk, and that's what kind of skews the numbers.
Dr. Juliet Naku, the executive director of Butabika Hospital, called for more decentralization of mental health services to district hospitals to minimize cases of mental health admissions. She believes once treatment is made accessible to people, many victims will not need to crowd Butabika.
To try and change that situation, by advocating that the Ministry of Health or Public Service should recruit mental health workers in all health facilities around the country so that people can be taken care of before they become ill enough to need an admission.
As Butabika Hospital grapples with a high number of patient admissions, the Auditor General's report highlighted that a number of critical medical equipment and non-functioning as they broke down a long time ago without repair or replacement of their spare parts. These include the X-ray machine, oxygen concentrators, ECG machines, and the diathermy machine.
We have advised to prioritize maintenance of equipment and have the X-ray machine functioning. In our response, we say X-ray machine was purchased and installed by Ministry of Health, and by January 22, it was still under warranty. So we couldn't repair because it was under warranty.
Understaffing is another challenge affecting service delivery in Butabika, with only 410 staff out of 531 approved staff positions. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.